Hello, friends. It's time for Come Share the Joy, and I thank you for tuning in once again this week. My name is Deborah Schultz, and I am your host for the next 30 minutes. God is so good, isn't he? And America just celebrated a birthday, 246th birthday. Wow, that's getting pretty old, isn't it? And I thank God for the land of the free and the home of the brave, don't you? God is so good. I thank him today for so many things. I thank him the way that he blesses me, he takes care of me, and I thank him for you, my friend, that you've stopped by just to let me share the joy of my salvation with you. God be lifted up. You know, today we are going to celebrate freedom. We don't realize what we have, do we? I think lately we have decided, I personally have decided that I've taken a lot for granted. I've taken so much for granted throughout the years that God would just continue to make this a safe country and keep us from harm. But I think we've dropped the ball in a lot of things, but it's time for us to rise up as believers, as patriots, as people that love America. It's the birthday of the United States. And you know what? When the pilgrims came over, they came here. I'm going to tell you, they came here for religious freedom. They came here to escape poverty. They came here to escape warfare, political turmoil, famine, and disease. And lately, my friend, you can just kind of go back and see these things begin to take place. Our independence, our freedom. My, my. It's time to rise up. This is a great nation. This nation was founded in God. He is all over everything in this country. He has been good to us. Let us serve him. He said he would have no other gods before him. And that means none. I was telling the children at church today, they, independence. Oh, I cannot wait until I get 18 years old or 21 years old and I get to go out on my own and do what I want, when I want, and where I want. Yeah, it's all good to think about. But when you get out there, things are different. You know, I remember being at home. I used a certain kind of shampoo, a certain kind of hairspray, a certain kind of perfume. And when I got married and we were just getting started, you kind of had to do the bargain shopping. I took all that for granted. You know, we've taken a lot for granted. God has been good to America. He will continue to bless America if God's people continue to lean on him. He is our freedom. He keeps us free. You know, we, let me find my scripture. In John 8, 31 through 36, it says this. Then said Jesus to the disciples which believed on him, if you continue in my word, there are many disciples indeed, and ye shall know the truth. And the truth shall make you free. They answered unto him, we be Abraham's seed, and we never were in bondage to any man. How sayest thou, you shall make us free? They told him. These were Jewish people that were a little in, you know, they wanted to know what Jesus had to say. And he said, you can make us free. Ah, and Jesus answered and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committeth sin is a servant of sin. Isn't that true? You're a servant of sin. And the servant abideth not in the house forever, but the Son abideth forever. If the Son, therefore, shall make you free, you're free indeed. Now, if I went over and I was a servant to the Queen of England, 70 years, 80 years, till I died, I was a servant there. I would still be a servant. My friend, Jesus Christ came and he had us adopted into the family of God. If we believe on Jesus Christ, he will set you free. Not only will he set you free, but he will rock your world. He will show you things, that thou believest not. He is such a wonderful God. I love him today, and I thank him for what he means to me. John 14 and 6 said this. Jesus said unto them, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh to the Father except by me. Nobody's coming to the Father except by me. Jesus has given us freedom from death. John 3:16 tells us that. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. We can have everlasting life, my friend. All you have to do is accept it. You can either accept Christ as your Savior, or you can accept to deny him. That's freedom. We have a choice. We have a choice in this country to do good or to do evil. Now, the Word of God is all right there to show us how to live, how to walk, how to talk, how to believe. God is all over Washington, D.C. I ran into a video today, and it was about Washington, D.C., how everything in there, every building has scripture, every building has God all over it. We were founded. In God we trust. Our money even has in God we trust. Oh, I trust him today, do you, friend? I trust him with my life. And I know that he's going to take care of me. My mind went back to the children of Israel. And I could see them at the Red Sea complaining to Moses. And Moses is thinking, well, where do we go from here? There's no way out. They're right behind us. And they're going to take us. But God said, Moses, raise your staff. He raised that staff, my friend, and that Red Sea parted. Not only did they walk through the parted sea, the Bible says they walked through on dry ground. Now, you imagine that. Now, we've all been to the beach. We've all been to a lake or even in the stream, in a creek. We call it a creek here in West Virginia. And sometimes you'll get into that sand and you'll just, it just kind of tries to suck you down in there. But this said that they walked on dry ground. God is a miracle working God. And I believe right now that he is going to move soon. And it's going to shake our world. Love him today. Be with him. Spend time with him. Let him love you. Because he cares for you. The Word of God says it in Romans. There is therefore no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of the life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death. He has made me free. Do you feel free today? Do you feel free? Oh my, if you don't. Today is the day that you can receive Christ as your Savior and you'll have freedom. You'll be free. What hinders you? What hinders you from being free? The weight of this world? The Bible tells us not to yoke up with sin, but turn away. Walk away from sin. He can deliver you from addiction, alcoholism. He can deliver you from poverty. We got to trust God. Trust him this day. The Bible says, choose you this day who you will serve. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. For years I thought that meant that you can make your family serve the Lord. I can't make my family do anything. But Debbie, the Bible says that our bodies are a temple of the Lord. Choose you this day who you're going to serve. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Do you love him today, friend? Now, I just went out and did some street ministry. And Wow. Marty was on the show a few weeks back. She does a great work. It's time for us to go out there in the highways and byways and compel people to come in. That the house may be full. I don't know about you, but my attendance is down at our church. Our attendance is down. Where are the people? It's time to rise up. It's time to trust the Lord. But I was out on the street when I go out there and they love on people. And this lady's name is April Markham. And I went in, it's called the Blessing Tent. And once a month they put this tent up for ladies. And I thought, well, I'm going to go check this out. It's just in a little square in our town. And I'm going to do a video here shortly and you can see it. I walked in there and there was April and she began to tell me all about this tent. She told me, you see, that she knows where they came from. She too once was on the street. God has done a miraculous work in this lady. Wait till you hear her. She is so bold in the Lord and she knows what God has done for her and she wants to love on these women in poverty, on the street, drug addiction. They're just slaves to sin. She wants to love on them. She wants to make them feel pretty. Now, God has blessed her with this little tent, but I'm going to let you listen and let her share that with you. She is an amazing woman to do what she does. And all the stuff just keeps coming in. Clothes, shoes, purses, makeup, smell good, jewelry. That's April's. You see, that is what God has called her to do. Because she knows where those ladies came from. She knows what it's like to be in lack. Do you know? Have you been there? Could you share? Could you share what you have with other people? It's time for us to. It's time to share the love of Jesus that we have in our heart with other people. I love the Lord. And I pray that you're blessed just watching this, because this lady, she is called. And you'll see Marty running around there serving the people, serving them dinner, serving them drink. She's just an amazing little lady. But that is her life, because you see, she wants to reach out and help someone else. It's time for us to reach out, help people be free from the bondage of sin. And again, happy birthday to our great nation. Oh, do you know the eagle is our bird? But I think it was Benjamin Franklin wanted it to be the turkey. I thought, oh, the eagle is such a great bird. I wouldn't want to be a turkey. I think of turkey for Thanksgiving and Christmas, but not a national bird. I'm glad we're the eagle. I think God had a hand in that, because America, you are a great nation. And it's in God we trust. Believe in Him and you will be free. We will be free. Just like this great nation of America is free. God has blessed us and He will continue. I believe that. How will He do that? If we love one another. He said, love one another as I have loved you. So it's time to get out there and start loving one another. God bless you, and I hope you enjoy this segment of the show. I am here this evening in Logan, probably about 30 minutes away from my house, Street Ministry. A friend of mine, Marty, who was on the show a few weeks ago, she does this 3 days a week. She comes out into this square, and she ministers to these people. There are different ministers that come by and preach a word. She feeds the hungry. She clothes the hungry.
He defended this gospel with his life.
She loves these people.
That's how serious
this is, the call. You know, the Word of God says, go ye out into the highways and byways and compel them to come, that my house may be full. Speaking of a house, once a month, a couple of the girls that are on her team do this. This is a little tent set up for the ladies. who are in need, so they'll feel just how loved they are. And I'm going to show you just what they have in here. They get to come in here and be ministered to and pick out, I guess, as many things as they'd like to have. It's such a blessing. April, this is a blessing. I'm fine with the persecution. Listen to what Paul said. Tell me about your vision to do this. Persecutions
and suffering. I have been on the street before in my life. Jesus told us, it's hard to feel pretty when circumstances is kind of rough. And then I was in a good place and I was married and in a home. But money had to pay the bills and take care of the kids and buy stuff for the house. My husband had to have his habit.
Yes.
So I didn't get the pretty things. And God told me, he said, it's in your heart to give. He said, it's in my heart too. See, when you align your heart with God's heart, things begin to take place.
Yes.
And
there was a bloodline that the enemy feared. There was a bloodline that the enemy tried to kill.
He just wants every woman that walks these streets to know that she's way more valuable than she could ever imagine.
Yes.
Far more precious than God. Far more precious. And so he told me the specifics. He said, I want you to put together a little boutique.
And it's beautiful.
And I want you to ask people for donations. He said, they'll come. He said, but I want my word concerning women all throughout the tent. If you look, I've typed it out. And it's on each table.
Just how important you are to God.
Because the word of God doesn't go out void. And these women, they might not know what God feels about them.
More precious than any of these jewels right here on this table. Oh, tell what happened. I came today, and she meets me saying she has been blessed above and beyond.
And I was, because when I started this, I had just a few decorations.
Yeah.
God said, you can put that together, and you can do this with it, and you can do that with it. And I was just tickled just to be a part of God's plan. But then I was like, it started getting bigger, and I was like, God, I kind of need, I would like some things to make it a little bit prettier. And I only had one of these black holders.
Yeah.
It was my precious at home, and I said, God, I sure would like some more. And God did it.
Well, sure. Doesn't he always?
He always does. I said, God, I need some bags. I'd like to give these women some bags.
Yes.
That way they can put
their stuff in.
They can fill it full. They can have a pocketbook.
We've got purses. We've got clothes.
And socks and a little,
yes.
Everything. And I said, okay, I'd love for them to be able to have an armful, but put it in a nice bag. I wanted to. I said, plain white be fine, God. God gave me a bunch of these today.
Isn't that just like him?
With women all over it. Because this was on his mind way before it was on mine.
Yes, it was, April.
And he has a perfect plan.
Thank you, thank you.
And so I just thank everybody for praying, for being a part, for you coming down and singing. Everybody, for our brother giving the word tonight.
And you do know you're going to be on a TV program. That's what we're doing here. Called Come Share the Joy. Because you're sharing the joy of your salvation.
I am.
You know where God brought you from. Yes.
And I know where he brought me from. And I drove a 1997 car. In this day. Just a bit over a week ago. Now I'm driving a 2012, 14, I don't know.
Glory
to
God.
It's beyond what I ever thought or imagined. But God will do it.
That's who he is.
He cares about you.
Yes,
he cares about me. He cares about each of us. And he doesn't play favorites.
No, he doesn't.
If he'll do it for me, he'll do it for you.
Yes, he will. Awesome.
So
I think you have got some ladies ready to come in and be blessed. I'm going to go, but thank you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Look at all this. It's just never ending. There are shoes. There are clothes. Tons of clothes. Lots and lots and lots and lots and lots. This is what it's about. This is what it's about. It's about going out and letting people know Jesus loves them. Let him use you. God bless you. There is a God.
Yeah.
I have got to sing this on some courthouses and the state capitol, this song, and boy, I love it.
because people doubt a God. People doubt our God, who He is. Listen, He's going to show up soon. And He's going to let everybody know just who He is. There is a God. You're going to turn that up soon.
I can stop that one.
Oh, this is perfect. I need some more volume. Hallelujah. Oh, listen up. Everybody on this ground, there is a God. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Father. Some people question how the stars are hanging there in space. They say they don't know how that we came the human race. They call the very life of man a mystery with no cause. No answers to these questions may bring pause. I have a thought. Gift of life in a newborn baby's face. Oh, watch the sun slowly set to end another day. Or a sinner down on bended knees, giving all to Christ. Although I may not see Him with these human eyes,
Miss April. What a gift that she has. What a call that she has. And you know, she said she doesn't know where God's going to take it, but she just trusts Him. Just like for those bags. She said, Lord, I'd like to have some bags so these ladies won't have to carry this down the street. They can just fill their bag. And they just go in there and fill the bag. But while they're there, she ministers to them. She prays with them and she tells them about Jesus. Now, my friend, that's what you call baiting the hook. God wants to use you. I thank Him this day for you. I thank him what he has done in my life and what he has called me to do. And I thank him tonight for my sponsor, Old Hilliard Plumbing in Hilliard, Ohio. And that number is 614-777-9320. Oh, my friend, God is so great. He is doing mighty things. I thank him for the opportunities that he has given me to minister. I'll be in Columbus in the next few weeks, and I'll be ministering at a church near Hilliard, Ohio. And I'll be at the Ark soon, and I'll be in Frankfort, Kentucky. Pretty busy. God wants to use you. Let him. Let him use you. If you have a prayer need, if you have something you just want to talk about, someone you just need to listen. I listen. Call me, 304-687-3579. If you need prayer, give us a call. I have a prayer team, like I say, every week. They're ready to pray for your needs. They're ready and willing to help you any way that they can. My website is www.deborahschultzministries.com. Check us out. Be with it. Be bold. Be ready to let him use you. While you're at it, why don't you go on YouTube and subscribe to Deborah Schultz Ministries, and I'd love that. Helps us out. God bless you. Until next week, have a great day.